my parents gave me a chemistry set for Christmas. Now, a chemistry set when I was a kid was a seriously good piece of chemistry equipment with all sorts of things that I'm sure kids wouldn't be allowed to get their hands on today. The bedroom therefore suffered from several fires, floods. I'm still the 8-year-old kid wanting to mix up the chemicals. My interest is in helping us towards a truly sustainable energy future. And that might mean developing some of the technology that allows us to make best use of solar and wind, for example. So the problem there is that in both of those cases, the electricity supply that comes from those devices is terribly intermittent. So we can go from full generating capacity to none just because the cloud happens to float across the solar array. So there needs to be serious energy storage built into the system, and that's what we do.
So we have a small device to take this sample out.
We developed a new ionic liquid to allow a kind of energy generating device called a thermocell. And this is a thing a bit like a battery, but it runs continuously as long as one electrode is kept hot from some source of heat and then the other electrode is kept at room temperature. Ionic liquids don't evaporate. So we can operate these devices then up to 200 degrees. And that's the sort of temperature range where there are very useful sources of waste heat around.
Can you tell me what the peaks are here?
Yeah.
My group upstairs are very much focused on new kinds of battery chemistry, new energy storage technologies, water splitting technology, so taking water to make hydrogen and oxygen. We have our synthetic chemists who make these new materials, and they're interested in applications including direct thermal energy storage, so simply materials that can be heated up by sunshine and then deliver that heat back at some later point. But if we're working on something where we've got a glimmer of an understanding of what's going on and it's important, then occasionally we approach what we call a eureka moment. Because one of the things about the science is that the ultimate accolades are months and months and months down the track. You know, the moment in the lab is a little unpredictable, but you often know, you have this feeling, yeah, that was an important experiment. I think the world faces some serious problems right now in respect of energy and how we get our energy and how we use our energy. But I think there are solutions to that, that if the scientific community and the minds of our bright younger generations are applied to that, that we can find solutions. Any young scientist that's got an interest in helping resolve some of those planetary problems, I think there's a bright future for them.